Welcome to another exciting action-packed hour, fans of Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Professional wrestling the way it used to be and the way you like it. Hi, fans. I'm Bob Caudle along with Dr. Dirty Dutch Mantel. And Dutch, we got a great hour this week in
store. Great hour.
I tell you, it's going to be hard to top what went on here last week with all the action, all the excitement we had. But we've got another hour, fans, the equal to that and maybe even more so. We're going to see highlights of the Moondogs in action right here. We're going to go back and take a look on tape about an incident, if you can call it that. It was more like a war between the Bruise Brothers and the Heavenly Bodies. And an altercation at the river. You know what that means.
Yeah.
Chris Candido and that United States heavyweight belt that he said was going to go in the river. The mask is going to be at stake as the Bullet will be taking on Killer Kyle. And I say, we got to draw now for, you know, our Beat the Champ match.
That's my sole purpose in life, is stand out here and draw names out of a hat. And today, the lucky man to face the Dirty White Boy will be, let me see, what's this say? Prime time, Brian Lee to face the Dirty White Boy today in the Beat the Champ contest right here. Prime time, Brian Lee and the Dirty White Boy.
What are you doing drawing my name? I don't need the match.
That's the name.
That came. I have the money.
We can't do anything about it. It came out of the hat.
Cancel, Dutch. Dutch, cancel.
That's the rules of the game. Let's go to the ring.
No, I am not in the ring. I'm not wrestling Dirty White Boy. I don't need the money.
Fans, the next match on Smoky Mountain Wrestling is set for one fall, introducing at a total weight of 470 pounds, Larry Santo and Juicy Johnny.
Bob, what was that all about?
I think they're a little bit upset, wouldn't you say, Doug?
Tells me one thing.
That tells me that he don't want to get in the ring with a Dirty White Boy.
Oh, I wouldn't go that far with it. I'd say, he said he didn't need the money, and he wants to cancel it. Can we cancel it?
No, no way.
The Armstrong.
Scott and Steve Armstrong, man. That's in their way to the ring.
Fans introducing from Marietta,
Georgia. Armstrong family tradition right there.
75 pounds. Part of the Armstrong family tradition, Scott and Steve Armstrong.
Right there in the Smoky Mountain Wrestling ring right here, taking on Larry Santos and Juicy Johnny. You know, that's going to be quite a match between the Dirty White Boy and primetime Brian Lee.
Fans, stay tuned. He didn't need the money. He don't want the match.
Well, he probably doesn't want the match, and he probably doesn't need the money.
He's already got
$20,000. But fans, stay tuned. Right after this match, you're going to see the Dirty White Boy and primetime Brian Lee head up face-to-face right here in the middle of that ring, coming up next. Good move by Steve Armstrong on Juicy Johnny.
Brad Armstrong, look how high he got with that drop kick. Good arm drag and a takedown. You know, these guys are still in the hunt for the Smoky Mountain Tag Team title too, Dutch.
Well, they're still in it. But being in it and being the champions, that's a different story.
No doubt. Say, if you've got a business, fan, you'd like to have a personal appearance by the Armstrong or some of the other great Smoky Mountain stars.
Like me.
That's right. For your customers to come in to see and to get autographs, call Pam Lawson, 615-587-1273. She'll be glad to give you all the details about it.
And fans, if you have a business and you want Dr. Dutch Mantel there, call Pam Lawson and we can set it up. Good move by Steve on Scott, dropping right there on Juicy Johnny. They're trying to get Scott Armstrong back in the corner.
They got him in the corner right now. Dutch are going to double team it. Johnny missed it. Larry Santo was holding him back in the rope. Here's the tag now to Brad. Big, hard right hand. All four in the ring. There's a kick right there from Scott.
And they're setting him up for this Armstrong signature move. And he's
Boy, you're looking death and right in the you, eye from yeah, up there, Dutch.
I hate for a guy to get on the top rope.
Holy
and,
cow.
And then talk to you a little bit. One, two, three. Referee Mark Curtis. Cross Juicy Johnny down the Armstrongs, the winner. And the first match, and fans, don't go away.
He's looking you dead in the eye, Dutch.
Oh, yeah. Coming up next, Beat the Champ contest primetime. Brian Lee taking on the champion, the Dirty White Boy. We'll be right back. And this Beat the Champ, sometimes you don't know what name you're going to call out of the hat. But right now, we see the reigning Smoky Mountain heavyweight champion making his way to the ring, accompanied by Tammy Fish and the legendary Ron Wright.
Primetime Brian Lee. And you know, Dutch, they raised a real ruckus at the beginning of the program. They didn't want any part of it. But as we said, it was all legal. It was all on the up and up. All of the wrestlers have agreed to it, and there was no way he could get out of it.
Well, he wanted to cancel it.
No way.
And Brian Lee's a close personal friend of mine. I would have canceled it if I
this
could,
match is set but for I wouldn't one be following my for the Beat the Champ TV title. Introducing the challenger from Orlando, Florida, 280 pounds. He is the current Smoky Mountain Wrestling heavyweight champion, primetime Brian Lee. He is accompanied to the ring tonight by his manager and the first lady of Smoky Mountain Wrestling, Miss Tammy Fitch.
There you saw Tammy Fitch sort of attending to her man there, primetime Brian Lee. Oh, now, what's going to be strange about this match? Dirty White Boy's mindset has to be all messed up when he looks out of the ring and sees Ron Wright on the other side. The White Boy rolling in.
Charging
and he's,
him go after.
He's going after primetime Brian Lee with a vengeance. And referee Mark Curtis
came in. Dutch, I tell you, he's got murder on his mind.
Well, what you're seeing in the ring now, both men, both former Smoky Mountain heavyweight champions. I mean, once
he went in the air.
One's the current champion, primetime Brian Lee. Of course, Dirty White Boy had it for a while. And wrapping now Brian Lee's vest around his neck and using his own equipment against him.
I'll guarantee you one thing, Dutch. This is a no-holds-barred match. When you get two guys with the animosity, the hatred between them that these two have, and, of course, primetime Brian Lee, Tammy Fitch, what they've done to Mr. Ron Wright, that remains to be seen. But the Dirty White Boy think that they have really done something evil to him.
Well, don't make assumptions about what Tammy Fitch and Brian Lee have done to Ron Wright. That remains to be seen, like you said. But you see in the ring right now, I mean, look at that hammering shot from the Dirty White Boy.
Dutch, will you notice the tape around the fist of the Dirty White Boy?
Oh, he's ready. He is
ready.
Oh,
man, he's got it primed. He's ready for primetime Brian Lee. You know, this is the White Boy's fourth defense. If he wins this one and one more, he will retire undefeated. Dutch, he's already done it once, and that's unprecedented in Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Look at him go back to the attack. Everything he's done has just worked right to perfection.
Well, to catch the fans up to speed on this, it started a long time ago when Ron Wright put a $20,000 bounty on Tracy Smothers. The bounty was collected, but by primetime Brian Lee, and Dirty White Boy thinks it should have been his. And right now, he's taking $20,000 worth of frustration out on Mr. Lee right there in the middle of that Smoky Mountain ring.
Dutch, that, and of course, the fact that they've taken over and taking care of Ron Wright, and that's really in the Dirty White Boy's mind also. Lee now.
Wait a minute, Lee trying to leave.
He's gonna drag him back in by the hair of the head.
Lee was trying to leave. White Boy, like you said, grabbed him by the hair of his head and yanked him back in. Now, at this point, I don't think the Dirty White Boy has acknowledged the presence of Ron Wright as of yet.
Lee hadn't thrown a punch, has he, Dutch?
No, I don't think he's made one offensive move.
Wait a minute, now he's right out there behind Ron Wright. What's he gonna do? He don't roll Ron Wright right into Dirty White Boy, and then from behind, he gets the White Boy as the White Boy was trying to move Ron Wright out of the way.
Wait a minute.
Costly move on the part of the White Boy. A sneaky maneuver on the part of Brian Lee.
Well,
that was a sneaky attack, Dutch.
Well, primetime Brian Lee knew he had to do something to take the momentum away from the White Boy, and he used Ron Wright almost as a human shield and rammed him into White Boy. Now, I think White Boy was almost got out of the way, but he was trying not to hurt Mr. Wright. And when he turned, then primetime got him from the back. And now we see those big number 13 boots. And
he's on the attack now.
Look at White Boy, he is bleeding.
Yep.
He's opening him up.
Primetime Brian Lee turning it all loose right now, Dutch. He's going to whip him all the way across the ring to the rope. Look at that big foot again, right up into the face of the white boy.
Well, I'm going to say, white boy has Primetime upset right now. When you get a man 6'7", 6'8", and close to that 300-pound mark with no fat on him, I might add, when you get him upset, then you got to pay the consequences, and he's paying a dear price right now. White boy bleeding badly from the head now from that shot from Primetime Brian Lee in the post. Straight down to the mat.
Well, the dirty white boy came out. He was really pumped, Dutch, and sometimes you can be so pumped up, and the white boy may have been that he really may have spent himself right there in the opening minutes of the match.
You know, I talk about this a lot, but when a man works on adrenaline, that adrenaline has a peak point in it, and when that adrenaline burns out, you're gone. Yep. You're spent. You're finished, brother.
Right.
Now, look at Tammy Fitch outside the ring now. Very happy, very elated.
Look, Ben, and the face of the dirty white boy is a mess right now as Brian Lee now continues to pound him. He's got him just draped helpless over that second rope, and he continues to work and continues to attack him.
What I'd like to know right now, the mindset of Ron Wright.
Power slam, Dutch. He had all of his weight and power behind that one.
Big driving elbow from the champion, Brian Lee. In this match, of course, the winner gets $1,000. Dirty White Boy's fourth defense. Primetime Brian Lee wins. Of course, he wins $1,000, and he becomes the reigning
Dutch
TV champion.
$1,000 is a lot of money. To me, it's a heck of a lot of money. And to these guys up there, I don't know how much money it is to them, but they're not fighting for money right now. You know, they're fighting for pride.
Yeah.
And they're fighting each other for the hatred that they've got in each other.
What?
And for the fact that I can say, I took him on, I beat him, and I beat him to a pulp, and that's what they're trying to do to each other.
Primetime now doing target practice on Dirty White Boy. Into the buckle.
That's going to slow him down. The white boy got a foot right up into the face as Brian Lee came charging after him in the corner. Big roundhouse right hand and another one. And Lee's staggering and reeling back into the corner. He's just sitting on the rope now. He looks helpless at the moment.
White boy fighting now on instinct, bleeding from the head. Referee Mark Curtis, he needs it. Referee Mark Curtis better watch out. Wait a minute.
Tammy.
He's got the glove on.
Gave something to Lee, but the white boy ducked under it. Wait a minute. There goes Tammy Lee. She sprayed something into the eye. There's the bell.
Wait a minute. We got a disqualification here. Tammy Fitch in the ring.
Here is your winner. Here is your
dirty white boy. Put the Bucksnort blaster on Primetime Brian Lee. Now Lee gets him with that loaded glove. Wait a minute.
Tammy Fitch just rolled right into the ring.
Ron Wright is getting in the ring.
Something right into the eye.
Ron Wright is getting up.
Big right hand from Ron Wright to Primetime Brian Lee. Now, and Lee came back with a right. I can't believe it.
Ron Wright is down.
What's Ron Wright doing in the ring?
I don't think he can walk. He couldn't stand.
Look at Primetime Brian Lee way up under the rope. Right down onto the knee of Ron Wright.
Right on the knee of Ron Wright. And he's hammering Dirty White Boy with a glove again. And Mr. Wright is out of it.
He's lying out helpless in the ring. And hey, Lee's not finished. There's another one to the knee.
Well,
I can't believe he's doing it.
And the white boy down, Ron Wright down. I cannot believe Ron Wright got out of the chair to help the dirty white boy. A big kick by Brian Lee. Now he lost $1,000, but he is getting even with the dirty white boy and telling. Now he's telling, what's he saying, old man, get up, I can't.
Saying something about old man and just kicking now at Ron Wright out in the center of the ring. That's a lot of disrespect. He didn't have any respect for him at all, Doug.
I don't know. Look at White Boy.
You know, the White Boy, look at him over there with Ron Wright. He looks like he's almost crying over Ron Wright. Ron's been like a father to him, Dutch. No doubt about it. Fans, we're going to be back.
Wrestling fans, Smoky Mountain Wrestling is coming to Prestonsburg, Kentucky, Friday, November 12th at 8 p.m. at the high school gym with all the top stars. We'll see you in Prestonsburg. Pikeville at the college gym, Saturday, November 20th at 8 p.m. You're going to see a 3-on-2 handicap match, the Bonnies and Jim Cornette against the Bruise Brothers, also a Smoky Mountain street fight, Bryant Lee against the Dirty White Boy. Barberville, Kentucky, Knox Central High, Saturday, November 27th, 8 p.m. for the Thanksgiving Thunder Tour. Don't miss the debut of Thanksgiving Thunder in Barberville. Hazard, Kentucky Memorial Gym, the tradition continues. Thanksgiving night, Thursday, November 25th, 7:30 p.m. It's WIMT Channel 57 night. Kids under 12 get in for only 57 cents in general admission with a paid adult. The Four Faces of Fear in Hazard is a Prince of Darkness match, the Bullet against a mystery opponent. Also a non-sanctioned match, the Rock and Roll Express against the Moondogs for the heavyweight title, Brian Lee with Tammy Fitch against the Dirty White Boy, and the Heavenly Bodies coming to Hazard Thanksgiving night, taking on the Bruise Brothers.
You know something about these Bruise Brothers? They remind me of these rednecks up here in eastern Kentucky, up in the hills. They think, oh, I'm my own boss, I'm my own man. You aren't nothing. You people, you're coal miners, you've got a boss, you've got somebody that tells you what to do every day. Whether it's the guy that employs you or your stinking ugly fat wife or somebody else, maybe the cops, maybe your parole officer. Same thing with the Bruise Brothers. They decided they were going to go on making their own matches and talking for themselves, and they weren't going to listen to what Jim Cornette told them. So now they're in a lot of trouble. And right there in Hazard, Kentucky, we're going to show you, Bruise Brothers, just like all the rest of these people in eastern Kentucky, you've got to have a mind to be a leader. And you're stupid. You're ignorant. You're foolish. And Jim Cornette and his heavenly bodies are going to teach you a thing or two about professional wrestling and teach you a thing or two about staying in your place. Because I hate uppity people that don't know their place. So right there, Bruise Brothers, Hazard, Kentucky, the Memorial Gym, Thanksgiving night, everybody talks about turkeys. Well, we're going to carve you up like the biggest turkeys of all time, and then you'll see that the guy with the brains, he rules the world.
After all, they're calling for some medical attention
but
now.
Dutch, Ron Wright, old like he's been, his heart like it's been, in the wheelchair like he's been, why in the world would primetime Brian Lee do that to a man in the physical condition that Ron Wright is in?
Well, I can't answer that. I cannot answer that question right now, but Ron Wright, of course.
In the ring, he just tapped primetime Brian Lee on the shoulder, turned him around, big right hand right to the jaw of Brian Lee, and then Lee, and I cut him in on instinct as much as anything else. Lee came back with a big, hard right hand, flooring Ron Wright. That could have been instinct. When a guy hits you, he may have hit him without even thinking. But the fact that he got on the ropes twice, came off, down onto the knee, tried to break the leg, tried to damage the knee, that certainly was not on instinct. That had to be premeditated in every aspect by primetime Brian Lee. And listen to the hand from the crowd now as Mr. Ron Wright is being carried out of the ring and out of the arena.
What they were talking about his neck, talking about his knee. So, I think.
All right, fans, with me right now, here's Mr. Darrell Van Horn. Our second annual Thanksgiving event is coming up soon, Thanksgiving Thunder, the second annual here in Smoky Mountain Wrestling. You've been doing a lot of talking about the Egyptian Prince. It's gonna be time to put up or shut up soon.
That's right, the entire world knows that my Egyptian Prince is going to make his debut at the second annual Thanksgiving Thunder Tour. But the problem is, I can't find any competition. No one wants to sign on the dotted line. They've heard about his legend. They know that he is the most feared man in Egypt, and no one wants to sign. I can't find any single man to do it. So I want to ask the commissioners of Smoky Mountain Wrestling to do me a favor. Just to be fair, let him make his debut against any two men, any tag team here. It could be the Armstrong Boys. Fine. When he gets done with them, they'll have to go back to their old jobs working as towel boys in a Greenwich Village bathhouse. Or it could be that tag team from around here whose fan base is comprised almost entirely of 12-year-olds with poor eyesight and hairy palms who spend the bulk of their allowance on glue and Grateful Dead tickets. I'm talking about the Rock and Roll Express. Wouldn't that be a hoot? That would be almost as much fun as the time I had dinner with Jeffrey Dahmer. So it doesn't matter to me who it is. When they get in the ring, shut up, Cracker. When they get in the ring with my Egyptian Prince, they are going to fall. He's unlike anything you've ever seen. Screw your wigs on tight and get ready for Thanksgiving Thunder. My Prince makes his debut and changes the face of pro wrestling.
All right, fans, you heard it from Mr. Daryl Van Horn. Right now, let's watch the Moondogs in action.
Charmin Brothers, John and Jerry, look at Moondogs spot. Come off that middle rope and just cover him on there, Dave. Gets the one, two, three. That's it. And Richard Lee can get his Moondogs and get out of here. Oh, boy. Got that sign over there that he's beating the Charmin Brother with. Oh, boy, that he's covered. Right upside the head in there. Guys just getting out of hand out here is what they're doing.
You tell them, Dave, friend, and I'm sure there's a lot of boys sitting in the back watching this whole thing.
Oh, boy.
Tell them, Dave, friend, anybody that wants them, all they got to do, come out and take that trip up Moondog Mountain, baby.
The Moondogs throwing these guys over the table, using that number three wash tub on them. Smacking them with that big road sign.
Oh, boy, it's bad. Richard, I wish you'd take them out of here, would you? You won the bout already. Oh, this kind of stuff is just ridiculous for them to come in here and pull this kind of stuff out of here. Boy, it makes me sick to see them do that. Look at them beat the Turman brother and me.
They just keep going. Corey, let's bring a stop to it ourselves.
All right, fans, with me right now, here they are. Smoky Mountain Tag Team Champions, the Rock and Roll Express. Hey, Rick, you guys just saw that tape of the Moondogs in action.
Well, let me tell the folks around here something. If they do not know the Moondogs, they certainly will when they come in here to Smoky Mountain Wrestling, because they are a team that don't care. They'll come in the ring and hit you with 2x4s, chairs, bricks. If they can get a car in here, they'll do that and run over you. You see, Smoky Mountain would not even give these guys here a license. Yeah. See, you, this match right here is not even sanctioned. Yeah. But you see, Jimmy Cornette, we're not going to turn this match down. We don't have to wrestle if we don't want to, but we're not going to back down from any team that you throw at us. We don't care, Jimmy Cornette. We are the Smoky Mountain Tag Team Champions, and we're going to stay that way. We will do anything we have to, Jimmy Cornette, to keep you from becoming the WWF World Tag Team Champions and the Smoky Mountain Tag Team Champions. So you can bake on that. All the dreams that you have been baking on, you're going to see them slowly start fading away, because rock and roll, they're here to stay. All right.
All right. Rock and Roll Express fans, we'll be back right after we take this time out.
Hi, this is Tammy Fitch, and I'm here with Tammy's Tips. I know many of you in the Smoky Mountain area are underprivileged. You don't know what it's like to live in the big city. You haven't had the advantages that I have had. You're poor. So I wanted to do something to help you, because I, like Hillary Clinton, strongly believe in charity work. Many of you have come to me and said, Tammy, you're so beautiful. How can we be as beautiful as you are? Well, I can't work miracles, but I can give you the benefit of my knowledge of makeup, exercise, hair, skin, and nail care, and social graces. In weeks to come, I plan on taking a typical average woman of this area and transform her into an acceptable human being. Now, let's go to this week's installment of Tammy's Tips. Today, ladies, and some of you men should pay close attention. We'll be learning some exercises that'll give you a slim, sexy body just like mine. That's what you can get from working out every day. I know many of you are, 100, 125 pounds overweight, but if you follow this program closely, you can look normal no matter how obese, gross, and disgusting you may be now. Just look at Margie here. She's just like the rest of you. No exercise, a poor diet. The first thing you must do before you start any exercise program is have a proper diet. You must avoid fried foods, red meat, candy, and especially all fats. So Margie, what does your diet consist of?
Fried chicken, grits, hamburgers, and greens.
Well, that certainly explains quite a bit. But ladies, don't worry. If you follow my exercise program, you'll have your husbands looking at you like they look at their old hound dog on the first day of hunting season, as you say here in the hills. Music. Hit the music, you idiot. Ready, Margie? I'll show you what to do, and then you can follow. First, we'll start with some jumping jacks. Arms up, legs out. Arms up, legs out. Remember to breathe. Now we're going to do some high kicks. Legs up, up, and breathe, and breathe. Now let's see you. Jumping jacks, come on. Breathe. Good. Breathe. Breathe. Margie, that's terrible form. Do some high kicks instead. Breathe. Come on, faster. Breathe. Remember to breathe, Margie. Will you remember to breathe? Come on, Margie. Okay, skip that. Let's run in place. Can you run in place? Run in place. Good. Get the arms moving. Good. Keep going. Breathe. Breathe. Come on, faster, Margie. You're walking. Faster. I said run in place. Run. Faster. Margie, will you run faster, please? You're embarrassing me. Margie, will you run faster? Margie, what are you doing? Will you cut the music? Margie, what are you doing? Get up. You're embarrassing me. Margie, tune in next week for more of Tammy's tips. I'll make something out of you yet.
Well, fans, just remember that Tammy's tips is a paid advertisement purchased by Tammy Fitch. Enough said. Hey, Dutch, you know, last week Chris Candido won the U.S. Junior Heavyweight title from Bobby Blaze in a great match right here, and he said he was going to throw that belt in the river if he won that championship. And that's what he tried to do. But Blaze got wind of it, and here's what happened. Let's watch it, fans.
Shall we gather at the river? Oh, I told all you idiots when I won this championship that I was going to take it and throw it right in the lake, right where it belongs. Because I was shocked, amazed, and disgusted when Smoky Mountain Wrestling refused to recognize my WWA World Heavyweight Championship, but yet agreed to recognize this ugly piece of garbage, the U.S. Junior Heavyweight Championship belt. So now I got it in my possession. And you know, I've beat everybody in professional wrestling. Ric Flair, Hulk Hogan, Jushin Liger, J.R. Benson, I've beat them all. So now I'm going to take this championship belt along with every other belt that I'm going to win and throw it right in this disgusting river that's not like New Jersey, where we have beautiful things like hypodermic needles and medical waste in our rivers. And then there'll be no other title left to recognize in the world of professional wrestling but my WWA Heavyweight Championship of the World. And you know, I told that coward Bobby Blaze that he can come here and lay and watch as this piece of garbage sinks to the bottom of this river. And he didn't have enough guts to even show up. So Bobby, hope you're sitting there home watching this. Everybody, this belt is going to sink to the bottom of this disgusting muddy river right now.
Candido, don't! Don't!
What the hell? Oh, come on, guys. Come on. She did that here.
Get that, you son of a b***h! Oh, you son of a b***h!
What happened to me a few days ago in that river right there was the most embarrassing, humiliating thing that's ever happened to me in my professional wrestling career. People wonder, Bobby, why do you take so much pride in that U.S. Junior Heavyweight title? Well, someone like Candido takes no pride, but me, that's the first major title that I'd won, the biggest, most prestigious thing I've ever done in my professional wrestling career. And it sickens me to no end. It makes my stomach hurt to see Chris Candido walking around with a belt that has no value to him whatsoever. Embarrassing, humiliating, Candido. I know some people in Smoky Mountain Wrestling, and I'm going down to them, some promoters, and I'm going to talk to them, and I'm going to try to come up with a way to embarrass and humiliate you the way you did me right over in that river just a few days ago. You take no pride in that belt. I got here just in time last week, a couple days ago, Candido. You was in the process of dumping that title, the one I take so much pride in that river. I don't understand that. It makes me sick. It makes me sick. And the way you embarrassed me and humiliated me, like I said, I'm going to go to the promoters and I'm going to find a way to embarrass you, Candido, more so than you embarrassed me in that river right there.
Well, after an embarrassment like that, you know that Blaze is going to be out to get even, Dutch. He would, you would, I think any professional athlete would.
No doubt about it.
And we wish him luck. Fans, we'll be right back.
If you'd like to raise money for your school, club, or civic organization, and you'd like to see the excitement of Smoky Mountain Wrestling live in your hometown, this message is for you. High school and college athletic departments, sports teams, police and fire departments, JCs, civic groups, or any group wishing to raise money can bring the stars of Smoky Mountain Wrestling to town for a night of action and receive a portion of the receipt. Write to us or call Sandy Scott at 703-989-6819. Smoky Mountain Wrestling and your civic group, an unbeatable tag team.
Fans with me right now, it's a great pleasure to introduce to all our Smoky Mountain Wrestling fans a great Tennessee athlete, Mike Furness, from a great Tennessee athletic family. Doug Furness, a great Tennessee athlete also and a professional wrestler. And right now, Mike has signed a developmental contract with Smoky Mountain Wrestling. So we're looking forward to seeing him in the ring before too much longer. Mike, I know all the fans would like to know a little bit about your athletic background.
Well, first of all, I'd like to say it's good to come back and smell the Smoky Mountain air for a while.
Yeah, man. Right.
Our career got started several years ago, and we started very young. And recently, I've been in Italy. I've stayed there for about the last 9 years, immediately after I left University of Tennessee. And it certainly is good to be back. I love it here.
Well, I tell you, football is your background. You got a tremendous background in football. And I know that professional wrestling is something new to you, but you must really be looking forward to it, Mike.
I am looking forward to it. I certainly spent a lot of time, sometimes on the road with my brother, and I recently talked to him, and he said to be sure and tell everyone back in this way hello. And he's encouraged me, and I'm looking forward to starting with Smoky Mountain here with their developmental program, getting into some camps and learning all about the wrestling.
Well, I tell you, we're looking forward to seeing you in that ring. As I say, you've been a great athlete, and I know all of the fans of Tennessee and your family and everybody are tremendously proud of you, and we are too, Doug.
They've always been great people here. I appreciate all the support we've always gotten. And
Wait a minute.
Let me ask a question here. What is this? Is this the football corner or what, huh?
Well,
Orange. All I see right here is orange. That's real nice.
I don't want to take up too much of your time.
No,
it
you
looks
don't
like
want to take up too much of our
my
time.
My goodness, Mike,
you're an Insomniac's best friend. Oh, yeah.
That was a little bit rude, wouldn't you say?
No, he's
I
new.
I mean, just to come in and interrupt some guy like that?
Please don't interrupt while I'm talking. He is just, he's new around here, and he doesn't understand how things work. This is a wrestling program. I personally don't like football, especially University of Tennessee football. So that's the way that goes. Get the heck out of here. It's a wrestling program. Now I want to talk about something that happened last week. I'm talking about those stinking, no good, ungrateful Bruise Brothers. Go to that videotape, show what happened, and then I got a few words for the Bruise Brothers.
All right, fans, watch it right here.
Your boss says, so I got news for you. You've embarrassed me out here, and if you pull another stunt like this, then I'm going to make sure that you're back there in one of those biker bars like I found you hanging out with all the white trash, just like your stinking brother here. Bruise Brothers, I'm sorry, I apologize. Listen to me, I shouldn't have said that. I didn't mean to say something like that. I'm sorry, I lost my head. I tell you what, I believe it would be best if we went ahead and had the match like you say. And as a matter of fact, no tennis racket involved. Let's have the match like you say, and may the best team win, and I sure do apologize for what I said.
And right into the eyes of one of the Bruise Brothers goes some kind of powder out of the pocket of Jim Cornette. Cornette quickly out of the ring. I got his racket back into the ring. The heavenly bodies, both of them, attacking the other Bruise Brother. And Dutch, they've gone with a racket. They're holding him down. And look at Cornette beat him as he flails away with
the
racket.
What a tennis racket by Cornette.
Now out of the ring they go.
One of the big Cornettes is up now.
We still got a wild
They're tearing into the heavenly bodies. The heavenly bodies taking that ankle express. They're headed to the dressing room.
And here it is.
And the fight is still going.
Out.
But
between the Brood Brothers.
The body's out.
Wait a minute, they're working their way, Bob. Clear it out. Here they come.
Let's get the heck out of the way here, Dutch.
Wait a minute, we got guys. Wait a minute. Watch out. They're tearing all this equipment up, Bob.
Right out here now.
Get over here to the desk.
Watch out. Here they come to the desk, Dutch. We got several guys trying to get them apart, trying to get them separated now.
There goes the desk.
Oh, heavens, Dutch, they're about to wreck everything. What bad blood is there between these? We got five or six guys now trying to separate them, trying to get them apart.
Well, we got two
around the ring. They're fighting.
Bob, we got two separate fights going on now.
All around us, Dutch. And I tell you, we're in dangerous territory right now, too. Cornette, heavens alive, with that tennis racket. He wheels that thing like a bat. What a tremendous blow he lands with it.
Bob, we got going out the door
into the parking lot.
We can't quite see from our vantage point.
Right out of the arena, right out the door, and right out into the parking lot they go fighting.
Well, our microphone cord prohibits us from going out there and exactly seeing what's happening, but they're in the parking lot. Our Smoky Mountain Wrestling blood cam is outside, and I just hear a lot of noise going on. I can only get a glimpse of them out this door here, but it looks like they're out in the parking lot, and this is a gravel parking lot here right next to the Smoky Mountain ring truck, and it looks like those Bruise Brothers are romping and stomping on the Heavenly Bodies out there. It is a...
All right, there we got a look at it.
Let me explain one thing to you. First of all, I can't wait because it's not too long until the Moondogs will be here. And they're coming to take care of the Rock and Roll Express. We got a lot of things going on in the World Wrestling Federation. And the Moondogs will make sure that we don't have the Rock and Roll hounding us every step of the way.
They can't even get a license. They can't even get a sanctioned match
anywhere. But you see where the mistake was made. The Rock and Roll Express are so courageous, they don't want anybody to think they're the chickens that they really are, that they agreed to wrestle the Moondogs even though Smoky Mountain Wrestling wouldn't license them. So now it's going to be their funeral. But let me say something to you, Bruise Brothers. You know something? Let me ask you a question. Do they have school around here? Because if they do, maybe you could go and do your homework. Let me say something to you, Bruise Brothers. You're ungrateful. You're ingrates. I took you out of one of those no-good biker bars down there in Florida. I gave you a job when you didn't have one. I raised you up from nothing to be stars in professional wrestling. And what do? You backstab me and you backstab the Heavenly Bodies. If you had done your job properly with the Rock and Roll Express, then none of this would ever happen. But let me explain this so that all you rednecks out there can understand what I'm talking about. Like I told the Bruise Brothers, they are labor, I am management. And you know, I can see that none of these people here in Jellico have held an honest job for the past 15 years. But anybody out there that may at one time have been employed, you know that you don't go up to your boss and tell him what's going on. You don't go up to your boss and embarrass him in public. And you certainly do not go up to your boss and say, we couldn't do our job right. So Bruise Brothers, you have got a lesson in wrestling coming, and you got it coming real quick. You get in the ring with the Heavenly Bodies, and they're going to show you what real top-quality wrestlers are all about. And you'll be back in the unemployment line, back there in that biker bar, back there hanging around with all the rest of that trash, and back on food stamps, just like all these working-class, blue-collar people that say, oh, we think the Bruise Brothers did the right thing.
Fans, we'll be back right after this.
Bruise Brothers.
Now you can have the Bluegrass Brawl, Smoky Mountain Wrestling's wildest event ever on home video. Witness the three-team street fight, the Heavenly Bodies against the Stud Stable, against the Rock and Roll Express and Arn Anderson. Relive the magic of Tracy Smothers winning the Smoky Mountain Wrestling title. All matches complete and uncut. Send for a free merchandise brochure with tapes, shirts, caps, photos, and more. Write to Smoky Mountain Wrestling, P.O. Box 1279, Morristown, Tennessee, 37814. Order your merchandise today from Smoky Mountain Wrestling.
As earlier, we got a look at a little bit of the war that took place right here last week, and then from Jim Cornette, talking about these two big ones right here, the Bruise Brothers. What a war it was.
Let me tell you something, Jim Cornette.
We come out here and we try to please you, but you ain't nothing but a snake, boy. And granted, the heavenly bodies, you might be better wrestlers than us. You can do your flips and your fancy moves, but I'm gonna tell you now, there ain't nobody in the country can go toe-to-toe with me and my brother. I've been in bars, I've fought in every damn bar across this country. Bars, I've been in jail, I've fought with the best of them. And don't you think for a minute anybody's backed me down or put me down. Jim Cornette, you come on and get in the ring, you bring your racket, whatever the hell you wanna bring, I'll break you in half and pick my stinking teeth with them, cause we get it on, and we get it on right.
Fans, it's gonna be some showdown, no doubt about that one. Let's go to the ring.
Fans, this is your next match. The mask is at stake. Introducing first from Hell's Kitchen, New York, at 305 pounds, Killer Kyle.
All right, fans.
You know, isn't that very familiar music?
It is. It is.
And here comes Bullet Bob.
No, the Bullet.
Oh, come on now, Bob Caudle.
No,
I was born at night, but I wasn't born last night. I know that body anywhere. That's Bob Armstrong. But I tell you what, he's got considerable clout in that Smoky Mountain Wrestling front office. But if he gets beat, and he's got to pull that mask off. And of course, it's Bob Armstrong. And if he gets beat, pulls it off, then he is banned from Smoky Mountain Wrestling forever.
That's
forever.
Right.
Forever.
That's right.
Ever's a long time when you put four in front of him.
If it's Bob Armstrong, you're right.
If. Come on, Bob Caudle. Look at there. The Bullet. You know, Jim Cornette would be very happy if Killer Kyle wins this match.
Oh, I'm sure of that. And they go at it. Kyle came charging after the Bullet, and the Bullet with that back chop. Elbow from Kyle.
A little update on Ron Wright, fans. We're still trying to get word on the condition of him. We understand that he was taken to a hospital, but we don't know, we don't have an update yet. We just know that he was seriously injured and has been taken to a local hospital. And if we have any more word before we go off the air today, we'll let you know. Right now, Killer Kyle beating up on Bob Armstrong.
On the Bullet.
Okay.
The Bullet.
Okay, Bob.
The Bullet outside the ring.
I will accede to your wishes.
And it's Kyle slammed into the ring post by the Bullet. The Bullet on the attack now, down onto the floor. We heard Bullet say last week that he was accepting the challenge of Cornette to face an opponent in the Four Faces of Fear at the big second annual Thanksgiving Thunder Tour taking place Thanksgiving weekend, Dutch.
No. That's got a little condition on it. That's conditions is if he doesn't get beat.
Before then,
he makes it a Thanksgiving Thunder.
Yeah, that's right.
He might not make it. I don't think he'll make it today.
Well,
I hate to be a pessimist, but Bob Armstrong, and that's him, you know, he can call himself the Bullet or whatever he wants to call himself. But you know, to come back under a mask, you know, is that the epitome of hypocrisy?
The Bullet, then any doubt about it. Dutch, you talked about the second annual Thanksgiving Thunder. I tell you, Kyle almost broke him in two. Thanksgiving Thunder, second annual, November 25, 26, 27, and 28, Hazard, Kentucky, Knoxville, Tennessee, Barberville, and Johnson City.
Four Faces of Fear,
yes, sir.
Well, we see Killer Kyle now going for the hood on the
He's trying
the
to
bullet,
rip the mask off,
on,
isn't he?
On the Bullet.
The Bullet. I'm glad you finally got that right.
Okay,
Dutch.
The Bullet is down.
Killed
that win to the referee, Mark Curtis.
Holy
the referee
cow.
Has won his first match in Smoky Mountain Wrestling.
Fans,
no justice. No justice in Smoky Mountain Wrestling. All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's go right now. Standing by is Bob Caudle, and he's going to do an interview with the Bullet.
Fans, with us right now, the Bullet, and Dutch and I commented, we were certain that Jim Cornette, he was pulling for Killer Kyle up there.
Exactly right. He paid the right price, but he got the wrong stud. Now, he was a big man, but he didn't get the job done.
Now, the Thanksgiving Thunder Tour, the second annual Thanksgiving Thunder Tour, everybody's talking about it. Who will it be? Who will I have to face? Well, the four faces of fear, brother, I'm going to count them every one, two, three, four. I don't care how big they are, how bad they are, because I am a crusader. I am a man on a mission, and my good friend Bob Armstrong is going to be commissioner one way or the other. I don't care who it is, where it is, but I know come Thanksgiving, brother, there's going to be a thunderclap heard round the wrestling world. And when it's all over, Cornette, I'm going to be looking you dead in your eye, brother, because I'm still bad to the bone. Yeah.
All right, the Bullet fans, we're going to be back right after we take this brief timeout.
Wrestling fans, Smoky Mountain Wrestling is coming to Prestonsburg, Kentucky, Friday, November 12th at 8 p.m. at the high school gym with all the top stars of Smoky Mountain Wrestling. We'll see you in Prestonsburg. Pikeville, Kentucky, Pikeville College Gym, Saturday, November 20th at 8 p.m. with a 3-on-2 handicap match, the Heavenly Bodies and Jim Cornette against the Bruise Brothers, also a Smoky Mountain street fight, Brian Lee against the Dirty White Boy. Barberville, Knox Central High School, Saturday, November 27th, 8 p.m. for the Thanksgiving Thunder Tour. Don't miss the debut of Thanksgiving Thunder in Barberville. Speaking of Thanksgiving Thunder, Hazard, Kentucky, Memorial Gym, the tradition continues. Thanksgiving night, Thursday, November 25th at 7:30 p.m. It's WIMT Channel 57 night. Kids under 12 get in for only 57 cents in general admission with a paid adult. You're going to see the Four Faces of Fear. It's a Prince of Darkness match in Hazard, the Bullet against a mystery opponent. Also in a non-sanctioned match, the Rock and Roll Express against the Moondogs, the Heavenly Bodies against the Bruise Brothers, and the Smoky Mountain titles on the line at Thanksgiving Thunder in Hazard. Primetime Brian Lee with Tammy Fitch against the Dirty White Boy.
You know, Brian Lee, ever since I've been in professional wrestling, I've done a lot of mean and nasty things. I've took beer bottles and bust them over men's heads. I've took hangman's nooses and I've stretched them up by the ring post. And I've tried to run over a few people. I've done a lot of mean things. But one thing I've never done, Primetime, and that was pull an old man, crippled, up out of a wheelchair and try to end it. End it all. Do you realize this man is a living legend? This man I grew up watching. He was my idol. So I tell you what's going to happen on Thanksgiving night, boy. You should have used your head. You understand what I'm saying, Primetime? You should have used your head. That's that thing 3 foot above your ass. What's going to happen Thanksgiving night is I'm going to stomp your stinking skull in, and then if that little tramp comes by, I'll bust her right in her mouth. You're going down in Hazard, big boy.
Primetime Brian Lee fans, Sammy Fitch, I can't believe what happened earlier with Mr. Ron Wright. I can't believe you turned on an old man like that.
An old goat, you better believe it. You know, Dirty White Boy, you talk the talk, but you can't walk the walk, baby. You can't step in the ring with Primetime. You're just like the rest of these country boys. You're always gonna do something. You've always done this. You're always gonna kick somebody's butt. But what happens? I left you in a pile of blood with that old goat standing beside you, the old bald-headed, stupid geezer. Huh? Where you at now? Where you at, White Boy? Tough guy, tough guy.
But Brian, darling, there is one thing we're gonna miss, and that's Ronnie's credit card. I'm just so glad we are rid of that old goat. He was nothing but a newsie, nothing but a pain in my neck.
With a chair. The Dirty White Boy with a chair, and he cut Brian Lee a complete flip with it as he hit him in the head and sent him reeling. I am amazed that Brian Lee could even get to his feet after such a blow as that.
Brian Lee, you listen and you listen real good, punk. What you and that stinking little to me did to me has been done before, but better. When I looked out there and I seen Ron Wright laying in that ring, it made me sick to my stomach. I'm not coming after you as the New York City White Boy. I'm coming after you, Brian Lee, as the Buck Snort Tennessee Dirty White Boy. And I don't care if I got dues are going to be paid, and I'm the man that you got to pay them to.
I'll tell you, fans, you're talking about upset, and I think he got every right to be the Dirty White Boy. His friend, his longtime friend, his longtime manager, Mr. Ron Wright, his condition still unknown at this moment. That's going to wrap it up for this week, fans. Next week, our Smoky Mountain title match. It'll be Primetime Brian Lee against Bobby Blaze. We'll have our Beat the Champ match much, much more, all right here next week. And until then, so long for now.